It was the year 2003. Within these dark lanes of Kolkata, a 25-year-old IIT and IIM alumnus, shunning a bright and lucrative career, was searching for a deeper meaning in life. Thinking beyond himself, wanting to dedicate his life completely to serving deprived human beings rejected by society. This man has been looking after hundreds of children from highly vulnerable and impoverished backgrounds. By giving them back their lost childhoods and transforming their futures through quality education and long-term care and hand-holding.
One day it struck me that I should start a shelter home for children from very difficult backgrounds, and to whom I could dedicate my whole life. I could bring them up as my own younger brothers and younger sisters. So in that spirit, as a guardian to them, I can live my whole life.
When I decided to start a shelter home, I was first looking for land where I could start and then do some construction in that land. But even a small piece of land was costing so much that, I mean, it was just beyond any kind of imagination that I had. So I decided to start in a rented building. I therefore saw a few buildings and finally zeroed on a rented building which was near the IIM campus, and rent of which was around 12,000 rupees. So I started taking lectures for MBA aspirants in some coaching institutes in Calcutta, and through that I could meet this rent.
Started in a rented building in December 2003, Vinayak pooled resources from his own earnings through lectures. Support from his mother, who was Parivaar's first donor, along with that from some close friends and IIM batchmates, also started coming. As word spread about this effort, more support from wider quarters started trickling in. After a year, Vinayak managed to mobilize resources to buy 2 acres of land in a nondescript village called Barkalikapur in 24 Parganas south, about 25 kilometers from Kolkata, and build Parivaar's permanent campus there.
So in this way, I started. First 3 children I brought from a village around 20 kilometers from Kolkata, from extremely deprived backgrounds. And with that, after 15 days, another 10 children came. So in this, at the end of say 2 months, I had around 30 children already.
Every child at Parivaar is able to aspire to a brighter future based on the quality education and life skills he or she receives. Parivaar identified highly vulnerable children from varied backgrounds like orphans or single parent children, street children, and girls from red light areas vulnerable to trafficking. It also focused on children from highly impoverished tribal areas where even 2 square meals were not available and malnutrition was rampant.
At Parivaar, we have residential children from around 14-15 different districts, around 12 districts in West Bengal, 2 districts in Jharkhand, and a few pockets in Bihar and Chhattisgarh also.
Every year, Parivaar screens more than 1,500 cases of needy children for admission. These children are in the age group of 5 to 10. Parivaar has a detailed pre-admission screening process, which includes a site visit to ascertain whether a child is extremely needy and vulnerable and in need of long-term residential care. A key criterion in selecting the child is that there should be minimal possibility of the child dropping out from the Parivaar family.
We ensure that they are not looking for a short-term stay at Parivaar, just for say a couple of years or so, but for a long-term transformation. So if a child is admitted at the age of 5, our aim is that till higher education, which could be graduation and after that a job placement, till that level the child will be at Parivaar.
Most NGO and government-run shelter homes support the children till they attain the age of 18, after which the support is withdrawn. Parivaar has no such age limit.
I think that just like in a family, how a family supports a child to the last possible conclusion, it could be higher education, it could be job placement, depending on the potential of that child, giving all kinds of opportunities to make the most of that potential. So this was my vision, that just like a family, Parivaar will also handhold the child till the last conclusive stage, which does full justice to his or her potential.
Parivaar is now West Bengal's largest free residential institution, a home for more than 1500 children, served by a team of more than 175 deeply committed staff members. It has two separate campuses for boys and girls, each furnished with a school, dormitories, several dining halls, computer labs, libraries, recreation halls, and play fields. Children who had no opportunity of going to a school and whose nutrition, safety, and well-being were also under question now start aspiring to become teachers and engineers, and to pursuing many other such careers. A high happiness quotient, which is visible to anyone visiting Parivaar, is the reason for the negligible dropout rate. The atmosphere at Parivaar enhances the self-esteem of each child and opens up endless possibilities for the future. Almost 100% of the children appearing for the state board examinations for grade 10 and 12 clear the examination with decent scores.
The emotional and psychological nurturing of each child, I think that is of a very high level, and that I believe is the most important achievement of Parivaar.
More than 30 of Parivaar's earliest kids are now gainfully employed either after university level graduation or a skills program. They are working in different fields like nursing, hospitality, sales, retail, IT, BPO, accountancy, etc. A few are also working at Parivaar. Parivaar's central theme is that every child has a potential that needs a favorable environment for its fullest development. From 2016 onwards, Vinayak Lohani has expanded Parivaar to the new geographical area of Madhya Pradesh, where since then it has started 50 meals cum supplementary education centers called Seva Kutirs for children in selected impoverished tribal pockets in the districts of Devas, Sihor and Mandla. The venues for each of these Seva Kutirs has been provided by the local communities and panchayats. Usually it is somebody's house, the panchayat building, the school during its non-functioning hours, or even a shed or godown. At these kutirs, more than 4,800 children are getting nutritious meals like breakfast and dinner, along with highly beneficial supplementary education and life skills over the morning and evening shifts. The Seva Kutirs have a very high degree of community buy-in, with village women folk participating in the preparation of meals and other useful tasks. The Seva Kutirs combine two key themes, most crucial for children in the interior rural areas in the country, addressing the problems of malnutrition and low learning outcomes. In the pockets where these Seva Kutis have been set up, more than 80% of the children are severely malnourished. The Seva Kutis follow a two-shift engagement with the children from 7 to 10:30 in the morning and again from 4 to 7:30 in the evening. During the daytime, the children are sent to the local government school so that a continued engagement is established with them. The Seva Kutis are aimed at complementing the government schooling and not act as a substitute, but it lays much more emphasis and also provides quality inputs in the two critical areas of nutrition and education. In the morning shift, breakfast with seasonal fruits and milk is given, and dinner includes roti, sabzi, rice and dal, and this is served in the evening shift. Many other special nutrient-rich items like nuts, jaggery and other indigenous preparations are also given. Parivaar has more than 320 persons serving in these seva kutirs, who include teachers, nutrition anchors, educationists and persons engaged in continuous monitoring and evaluation. Parivaar is on course to set up 100 such seva kutirs in the most impoverished tribal areas of Madhya Pradesh by March 2019, which will serve 10,000 children. Parivaar is also building a residential educational institution at village Sandalpur in Devas district, which is modelled on the lines of Parivaar's residential institutions in West Bengal. Spread over an area of 17 acres, it is expected to be operational in 2019. Children from all these impoverished areas and Adivasi districts in Madhya Pradesh will be admitted into this residential institution. Inspired by the teachings of selfless service by Sri Ramakrishna and Swami Vivekanand, Vinayak Lohani is transforming the lives of thousands of destitute children. Parivaar, his vision, is now a dream fulfilled. This tireless journey of determination and dedication will surely provide a role model for many.